Let us start our discussion of power plant engineering. I hope we'll join very soon. We are discussing the different aspects of steam turbine itself. And we have discussed so far the what should be the velocity of a pressure pulse in a fluid itself. Now, just a second. Let us go through the velocity of sound in ideal gas. An ideal gas in an isentropic process, you know, that is PV to the power gamma. PV to the power gamma is equal to constant itself. It can be written in another form, P divided by rho to the power gamma is equal to constant. Now, by logarithmic differentiation, by logarithmic definition, then we have to log first, make the log, logarithm, and then differentiate. What will happen then? If you take a log here, it will log P plus minus log PR. And then if you take the differentiation, it will be log P by V. It will be just like here. dP by P, which is equal to gamma by gamma into P by rho. Since C square, or the as C square is equal to dP by d rho. Already we have discussed that dP by d rho, and P is equal to rho into PRT, and P is equal to rho into RT for an ideal gas. Then what will happen to C if we put this value of C is equal to, then C is equal to square root of gamma RT. And where R is the characteristic gas constant, which is equal to the universal gas constant divided by molecular weight of the gas. R, characteristic gas constant, characteristic gas constant, which is equal to universal gas constant divided by equal to universal gas constant. Universal gas constant divided by molecular weight, molecular weight of gas. So now, if Mach number m is defined as the ratio of actual velocity to sonic velocity. Now, what happened here? Mach number m m defined as ratio of equal to the actual velocity to the sonic velocity, actual velocity divided by sonic velocity. Sonic velocity. So that is m is equal to v square c. That is m is equal to v by c. M equal to V by C itself. Now, M greater than 4, flow is supersonic. If M greater than 1, flow is supersonic. Flow is supersonic. Means it is faster than sound, faster than the sound. When m is less than 1, the flow is subsonic. And when m is equal to 1, flow is sonic. M equal to 1, the flow is sonic. And flow is sonic. Means flow is supersonic, means flow is faster than the velocity of the sound. Flow is less than 1, is flow is less than the velocity of the sound, and flow is the 1, flow is equal to sonic, means equal to the velocity of the sound itself. Now, what are the stagnation property? Now, the isentropic stagnation state is defined as the fluid, as a state, a fluid in motion, as the state of a fluid in motion, which reach if you are brought to rest isentropically to steady flow, adiabatic, steady flow, adiabatic, zero work output device, brought to rest. State, stagnation property state is defined as state is defined as the state of fluid in motion, that defines the state of a fluid in motion equal to state of a fluid in motion of a fluid in motion. State of a fluid in motion, which would reach, state of a fluid in motion would reach, if it were brought to rest isentropically, to rest isentropically. Isentropically. That is means how the fluid will behave. If you put it in stagnation state, means stagnation in terms of the meaning of stagnation in it is stallment or halt. If the stagnation property state of a fluid is when the fluid is brought to rest isentropically, then what in steady flow, what will happen to the state of the fluid? If it's brought to rest isentropically in steady flow, adiaphatic zero in a steady flow, adiaphatic 0 watt output device. In a steady flow, adiabatic, batic, steady flow, adiabatic, 0 watt output device. It's a reference state, and this is a reference state in compressive fluid flow, and commonly designated as with subscript 0 itself. The stagnation enthalpy is related to the enthalpy and velocity of the moving fluid. All these terms stagnation, the stagnation does the stagnation enthalpy, thus the stagnation enthalpy. Enthalpy H0 is related to the enthalpy and velocity of the moving fluid like this. H0 is the stagnation enthalpy, it is the velocity of the enthalpy of the moving fluid plus V squared, the velocity of the fluid divided by 2 itself. So what will happen here? If we draw a curve like this, that is one is through H. And this is true S, means enthalpy entropy diagram. And we have two curves here. One is for H0 and one is for H. This is for H, this is for H0. And this curve is, this is H0 here. And this is H here. This curve is P for static pressure and P0 for static pressure, stagnation pressure, zero. Stagnation pressure. Static pressure. Just 1 second. pH is static pressure itself. Now, for ideal gas, we know for ideal gas, Cp is the specific heat at constant pressure is equal to T0 minus T and is equal to V minus V squared by 2 itself. Whereas P is the specific heat at constant pressure, T0 is that temperature of the stagnation pressure, T is the temperature of the running fluid, V is the velocity of the temperature itself. Now we know with this equation we can write if the property of this subscript is to denote static properties itself. That Cp, we know Cp is equal to gamma by gamma into R divided by gamma minus 1. T0 by T is equal to 1 plus gamma square V square into gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into gamma RT. Using equation and the Mach number, using this equation and the Mach number itself, equation 7.4, that is the we know is C is equal to square root of gamma RT and the Mach number with this equation will reduce to T0 equal to by T, T0 by T, 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m square. The stagnation pressure P0 is related to the Mach number and static pressure in the case of ideal case with the following relation. Sir, I am writing down one thing. The stagnation P0 is related to the Mach number itself and the static pressure in the case of an ideal gas and related to the Mach number of static pressure in the case of ideal gas by the following relation. Static pressure is equal to P0 by P is equal to T0 by T. T0 by T, gamma minus 1, gamma minus 1. Equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 to m square gamma by gamma minus 1. What is the properties of? So we have got a relation between P0 and T0 by T, gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is given by 1 minus gamma minus 1 by 2 into F squared into gamma by gamma. We know gamma is equal to 1.4, m is the Skolnick velocity, we do, m is the Mach number, which we are supposed to be known to us. So the ratio of stagnation pressure to actual pressure, you can, to actual pressure of the flowing fluid, we can really have it. Now, what will happen to subsonic and supersonic nozzle? Subsonic and supersonic nozzle. What is this? The isentropic flow through a nozzle for any isentropic force for any isentropic flow, then through a nozzle, H0 is equal to H plus V bar square by 2. And since stagnation enthalpy does not change, Stagnation enthalpy does not change, means h0 remains constant. H0 remains constant. So dh is supposed to be equal to minus v into dv. So if we take a derivative of both sides, we have h0 will, if we take a derivation, if we take a derivative, then it will happen dh is equal to minus 2 dv minus v into dv minus v into dv. V is a vector velocity. These two will cancel by these two, times two, and v into dv will be the derivative, so the derivative. And this is, you have to go in the left side, you can, it will be, it can become equal to minus. So from the property relation, from the property relation, from the property relation TdS, dh minus vtp, TdS dh minus vtp for isentropic flow. For isentropic flow, where there is no change in entropy, that is dS is equal to zero. This equation leads to dH equal to dH divided by vdP or dH by dP by rho. This is equal to equation reduces to equation. Equation reduced to dH is equal to vdP. dH is equal to dP by, oh, now, what is it? It is just to dH by dP by rho. Now, so with these two equations, 7.7, 7.8, just like this, just we have formulated from this equation as well as this equation. From these two equations, what we can write down, dP is equal to minus rho V dash into dV dash, or dV my dV equal to less than zero. Now, therefore, as pressure decreases for flow through a nozzle, the velocity also increases, and vice versa itself. This continuity equation thus becomes, if pressure increase decreases or flow for flowing through the nozzle, velocity increases, and if pressure increases flow for flow, the velocity will also decrease itself. The continuity equation becomes the equation becomes omega into port omega into rho av and rho omega rho into v. That if for logarithmic differentiation by logarithmic differentiation, we got d by rho d rho by rho plus d a by a plus d v by v. Or d a by a is equal to minus d v by d v. Or dA by A is equal to minus dV divided by V bar minus d rho by rho. Now, if we substitute this to this equation, dP is equal to d rho by V. If we substitute it here, then what will happen? dA by A, substitute from 7.9. If we substitute dP here, just d rho by V, substitute dP here, dP by V here, what will happen? From equation 7.8 dP. Then dA by A will become dP. We're just replacing dV itself. dV is equal to dP by rho V square. dP by rho V square. That will be both the minus will cancel each other, and dP by rho V square minus dP by rho minus d rho by rho. So dP minus, if we write it like this, dP by rho V square, dP by rho V bar square, it will be multiplied by 1 plus or minus V square d rho by dP. Or dA by A, or dA by A, dP by rho V square into 1 minus M square. Also, we know that we can replace it. We can reduce it like dA by A is equal to m square by m square minus 1 dV bar by V. When m is equal to 1, we know when m is equal to 1, LS velocity is subsonic as the Fourier area 4 decreases and the pressure decreases as velocity increases. So m is, velocity is less than subsonic. As flow area decreases, the pressure also decreases and velocity increases. For subsonic flow, a convergent passage becomes a nozzle. In figure 7.8, and a divergent passage becomes a diffuser. When m is greater than 1, when inlet velocity is supersonic, at flow area, as flow area decreases, the pressure is increases and velocity decreases itself. As flow area A increases, pressure drops and velocity increases. So for supersonic flow, a convergent passage is a diffuser and divergent passage is a nozzle. So the result what we have got when m less than 1, the flow is subsonic. Means less than the sonic velocity. The flow area decreases, the pressure increases. If flow area decreases, pressure also decreases. Pressure decreases, but velocity increases. And thus, a convergent passage, which is like this, this becomes a nozzle itself. It's a nozzle. Which means this passage for a subsonic flow, we have low pressure fluid and fluid as the area here is less than here, area here is less than area here. With the reduction of this area, pressure will drop and velocity will go up. And for supersonic flow, for supersonic flow, m greater than 1, that is supersonic flow, the flow area, the flow area decreases. Flow area decreases, but velocity also, the pressure increases, velocity decreases. The pressure increases and velocity decreases. So here it is, the conversion passage which defined as, so a conversion passage is defined as a diffuser. So what will be the effect of that change on sending a supersonic? It is like this. So you have like taking a drawing of the nozzle itself. M less than 1 means subsonic, or M1 is equal to 0.2, with the pressure of flow. Pressure flow comes inside is M1, and M2, which is coming out, M2 is equal to 0.8. So Mach number increases here as it is the vice product of the nozzle itself. If it is nozzle is like this, M less than 1, and M1, 0.7. M1 is equal to, sorry, bhul hoye gelo. M1 will be equal to, say 0.7, or less 7. M1 equal to 0.7. And what is going out? Which M greater than 1 with higher velocity, means M is Mach number is more than 1. Means here Mach number is less than 1, is Mach number is increasing to more than 1. So velocity as for the diffusers is increases here. And here, in another case where it is like this, nozzle is like this. This is also like this. M is greater than 1. M greater than 1 is M1. M1 is equal to 3.2. And M2, 2.4. So here also Mach number for 1, it was 3.2. Here, it is supersonic, it is greater than 1. It is reduced to a certain extent, but did not go less than the subsonic, like this. Here another problem is like this. It is uncertain divergent flow. M greater than 1, and M1 will do 1.8. M2 is equal to 3.2, and so here it is more than Mach number. M is more than supersonic, or 1 is more than the sonic Mach number. So M2 after the flow, M1 here is m1 is it has m1 is 1.8, is more than supersonic, its velocity increases to 3.2. This is the subsonic flow, subsonic diffuser, subsonic nozzle, which is called subsonic nozzle. This is subsonic nozzle. This is subsonic diffuser. Which means when the velocity is going down, it is behaves as a nozzle, which means the pressure went up. So it is behaves as a nozzle. And when velocity goes up without the expense of pressure, it is called as diffuser itself. And here it is supersonic diffuser. And see, supersonic diffuser means Mach number velocity is reducing from the incoming to outlet. So it is diffuser itself in the supersonic state, and supersonic when it decreases, it is supersonic nozzle itself. Just opposite, supersonic nozzle itself. Then let us go for critical pressure and choke flow itself. Let us draw a diagram. Let's go here. Critical pressure ratio and choke flow. Critical pressure ratio and choked flow. This is this, it is becomes, this is a, m equal to 1 and m less than 1. So here it is subsonic. It is supersonic. Now what happens? Let's go through the equation itself. One second. Just finish it. So what is the mass flow rate of a choke flow what is shown here, the mass flow per unit area is given as omega divided by A, P into P itself. It is P, P to the power bar, P is because it's a vector quantity itself. Or the mass flow is equal to V, rho, into Q, rho into C into M. Rho for the, the density of the system, M for the Mach number, C is the velocity itself. Now, if we reduce this further, if we put P divided by R to the power M to the power gamma RT, where CM stands for gamma into RT, where M is equal to, where plus M is becomes gamma divided by R to the power root into P0 into M divided by square root of T0, multiplied by T0 by T to the power half or square root into P0, P by P0 itself. Or gamma becomes the same, into P0 by T0 for 2 C is same, but T0 by 2, and P0 by 2 is by T0 by T, gamma divided by gamma minus 1 itself. So omega A, which is reduced by this one, square root of gamma by R, multiplied by P0 into M, P0 is the stagnation pressure, T0 stagnation temperature, P0 into M divided by M is the Mach number divided by T0 itself, and multiplied by 1 plus 1, divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 into F0 to the power gamma plus 1 by 2 into R1 itself. Since P0, T0, V0 itself are, then P0 here, T0 here, velocity V, these are all constant terms, and R are constant terms, the discharge by unit area is totally functional of Mach number only itself. Gamma R, T0, these three terms are all constant itself. So omega 1, the gamma R, gamma A is equal to M itself. It's a function of Mach number only. Only there is a particular velocity of M when omega is maximum. Differentiating with respect to M and equating to 0, P by omega A is equal to gamma by A into P by A into thus, this is we are equating to 0. So this will reduce to 1 minus m squared gamma minus 1, 2 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m squared is equal to 0. Or this can also do it if put this to outside, or this to right side, and it will become m squared into gamma minus 1 plus 2 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 by 2. This is gamma minus 2 into gamma minus 1, and these two is cancelling each other, 2 into gamma minus 1 into m squared itself plus gamma minus 1 m squared. Okay. But m square is equal to 1 or n is equal to 1. So the discharge omega by A is the maximum when m is equal to 1 itself. And V is equal to Cn R gamma T to the power half to the gain by logarithmic differentiation. We can go to dV by V, dt dm by dV by V into dt, dm by m into 1 by this dip, dm by dv by v, not dt by dt. This case, we have start to dm by m plus half into dt by t. And t by t0 is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 into m squared to the power 1. So again, by logarithmic differentiation, it will become, as t0 is constant, so dt by t, and gamma is also constant. So gamma minus 1 m squared to 1 plus gamma minus 1 m squared into dm by m. So dv by v, 1 minus gamma minus m square into dm by m. So dA by a is m square minus 1 dv by v. We can conclude dA by a, m square minus 1 dv, m square plus gamma minus 1 by 2, m square itself. So we are stopping here for the time being. We'll go for the next, the demanding portion of the meeting itself.